You have to excuse me about the lighting. I don't have all the fancy lights yet, so I'm just in my bathroom. This is the best lighting I have at nighttime. I just found out that Dr. Conrad Murray was convicted of killing Michael Jackson. What? I'm just going to say it. Michael was a dope fiend, and Michael was putting his own stuff into his own veins. Dr. Murray had to come in there and find the Negro half dead. Why don't we just all go out and invest in some white sheets and some nice thick ropes from Home Depot, because it's evident that the United States of America is back in the business of lynching. That's what I have to say on this. This is wrong. It's ridiculous. Do you know how many addicts, if they had the resources, would have a room in their house for their dope man? I mean, really? That is an addict's ideal. Alcoholics would like to live at a liquor gin. That's just how it is. Those are facts and realities. So now we're saying that, oh, well, if an addict happens to be wealthy, and there are many wealthy addicts out there, and they all go into rehab if they survive, and most of them are addicted to pills. Guess who they get those pills from? They get them from doctors. But the first doctor that we want to sit up and charge with murder, the first doctor we want to charge is Dr. Conrad Murray, an African-American doctor who I admit was a fool and crazy about some money, probably had some money problems like most doctors do. Most doctors have money problems. Most doctors make poor choices with money. But that is not what this is about. Because somebody is a fool, sees some dollar signs, and takes a legitimate job watching an addict to make sure they don't die, which is what the man was doing, now that puts them up for a murder charge if they happen to be African American. California, you're wrong. California, you are wrong. And to all y'all Uncle Tom fools out there talking about, well, see, he is a doctor, and he was in the house, and that was a dangerous drug. I just want you to know, my father was an addict, and he died, and he was taking the same drug that Michael Jackson was taking when he died. And the reason for that is because when you are an addict, and your body is so used to crack cocaine and all these other things, if you start to experience any pain, they got to hit you with the heavy stuff, because lightweight stuff does not work on addicts. Addict systems are already used to that lightweight stuff. You got to go right to the real. And that stuff that they gave Michael and my father was taking it, my father was flinching in pain on that stuff. So it is realistic to believe that Michael could have been experiencing some pain while on that. Michael was trying to work. He was trying to dance through a lot of pain. He was determined to do some things that, you know, not recognizing that he's an old man, he needs to hire him some dancers, stand in the background and sing. But oh well, we lost him. And now, Dr. Conrad Murray, we're having to deal with this. I'm sick of this madness. I'm sick of these Uncle Toms. I'm sick of these Father Georges. I'm sick of these masters. And I'm sick of these Ku Klux Klan. I'm sick of these sheet-wearing skinheads undercover coming out so they can do somebody. And it's wrong. It's just wrong. Okay, so that's what I have to say. I know that there are many of you who aren't going to like it, but it's the truth. It is the truth. And there's more madness going on in California than that. I'm in California, and I'm sick of California's madness. I'm sick of the witch hunts for African-American professionals. I'm sick of the nooses they have out here. They have nooses at union jobs where white folks are running around and hanging up nooses ever since Obama was elected. So that's what Dr. Conrad Murray walked into. And not one of these individuals who puts on these white sheets and these witnesses and brings them to work has ever been prosecuted. Well, that's freedom of speech. I'm just going to leave it at that. That's the madness. It's the madness going on in California. And I welcome comments and I welcome video responses. And I'm particularly wanting to hear from all y'all Uncle Toms out there, white, black, and Puerto Rican, who want to convince me that the doctor should have lost his license for practicing medicine. Because that's what he was doing. He was practicing medicine. Okay, his patient was a drug addict. Half the doctors in California, patients are drug addicts. Fact. Drug addicts love to go to the doctor with pain and get pills. Period. That's a reality. So before you go and deal with a situation where our whole society is broken and you want to take it out on one doctor that because he's a brother and you're mad because a brother got a job, Michael Jackson was a grown 50-year-old man. He was a dope addict and he was willing to pay money to have a doctor in the house so that he thought he could survive his addiction. And it didn't work. I have one more thing to say. To all y'all black folks out there thinking about doing something on the line, lynching season is in. You know, pull out your song, pull out your Billie Holiday song. Because I'm here to tell you it's strange fruit swinging on the Southern California vines. It chills the body, but it doesn't chill the soul. This is strange fruit. Strange fruit. Keep your eyes open. Watch your back.